making some breakfast for Riley. He's gonna have like an egg McMuffin type of sandwich. Oh, I gotta chop that up with two hands and I'm super sore, so I'll be back and I'll show you his sandwich. I'm sure I've showed you this before, but I'll show you a sandwich when it's done. And it is 8:30, almost 8:30. Alright, so it's ready. The egg is just, I flipped it and it's, whenever I cut it, it's gonna bust. But there's a piece of mozzarellissima cheese down there. And that's it. So I'm gonna cut that. Do you wanna come hold the camera for a second? And mommy will cut this?
Yeah.
Right there. Hold it so that they can see when I. Go, simple breakfast sandwich.
What is there any bacon in it?
No, mommy didn't cook no bacon or ham. It's meatless. Well, not, yeah, meatless in a sense. Clip that you guys just saw was the ambulance having to come pick up Jay at dialysis. He's not feeling well. He's there they are up there. He's got very bad pains in his stomach and he's vomiting, and usually that's a trip to the hospital, in the hospital a couple days. So I told him call the ambulance because he's gonna give me a hard time once we're home. So they're gonna take him to the hospital and I'm gonna go home for now, because they usually just hook him up to an IV and it's the waiting game, and I really don't want to go into the hospital if I don't have to. I've been through this a million times with him, so. Yeah. So I will update you guys in a little bit whenever I know more what's going on. I'm gonna go home and yeah, hopefully I don't have a hard time getting there, so talk to you guys in a bit. And of course, you can't see it, but I'm driving through a snowstorm. You can't really see it all that good, but it's snowing. I hope I don't have a friggin' hard time to get up my hill. Alright, I'm gonna put you guys away. Chatting the whole time, and then towards the end one of the dialysis nurses come in and said, are you Jay's girlfriend or whatever? And I said yeah. She said he's heart sick and he wants you to go see him, which is like not really normal, because you know, if usually, like, they gave him Gaviscon, they gave him there, and we see a doctor and all this and that, so it could just be, could be something that he ate, but usually, you know, it'll pass and he doesn't really puke if it's something that he ate, or if he's got, you know, indigestion, usually a Tums or Gaviscon or whatever helps, and it's not helping, so that's why I know. I've been through this enough with him that I know. So I think it was the better choice to call an ambulance instead of having to him come home and having me all stressed out, not wanting to go to the hospital, and then deciding he's going to want to go to the hospital, and we're in the middle of a snowstorm or something. So I think that's just better that way. So I'm going to go home, and in a little while, once he gets like established and all that there, I'll give it about an hour and a half, and then I'll call the hospital and see what's going on. If they end, you know, if miraculously he starts feeling better, and I'll have to come down and get him later on tonight, but I have my doubts. I really think they're going to keep him. Hopefully they don't ship him down to Bathurst, which is an hour away from here. Although he would be in better care down there, it's just, obviously it's closer up here, but that's, I don't know, we'll see what goes on with that. I'll keep you guys updated anyways. But yeah, not a great way to end the day, for sure. And, what else? The sunset's super pretty though, like, I don't know if you guys can see. It's hard to see. But anyways, so that's that. I wasn't expecting the day to end like this. It really sucks. We're supposed to get snow tomorrow, so I really don't know. Oh, there's a cop. I'm gonna slow down a bit. Anyways, they don't have dialysis around here other than where we were for dialysis, and that's why they would have to ship him down to the other hospital, because the other hospital, what we go to is a hospital, but it's more like a clinic-y hospital, a clinic hospital, I don't know how to say it, but they have an emergency that you can go in and stuff, but they're only open from a certain time to a certain time, and they have like the, you know, they have the ECG machine and all that stuff there, and a dialysis unit, so, and here you guys are, and you're, ugh, you guys are probably watching this all crooked, just lovely. Anyways, I'm gonna go, and I don't know, maybe I will turn you guys on when I'm driving up my mountain. I will see. That's a little bit of a better angle, eh? Oh, so this is my drive home. Not too many people live on the, this is like the highway, so. Stuck right at my ass. If he's gonna pass, I wish he would pass already. Make me have to slow down. So I have no idea what I'm gonna do when I go home. I got a migraine and I am sore as can be from shuffling yesterday. Obviously, I used muscles that I'm not used to using. There. course not. You're just going to continue to ride my butt. Oh, la 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 la. The thing that sucks about the people that live, well, anywhere really around here, but I've seen a lot of mail, busted mailboxes. They have their mailboxes on the side of the road, and there's just so much snow, and I've seen a lot of busted mailboxes. I don't imagine they're that cheap, so. Alright, I'm almost at the bottom of my hill. Just figured I'd give you guys the full tour going up. This guy's still on my butt. Traction, so, but hopefully I don't meet anyone, because if I do, I'm screwed. I'll have to swing the car around and back up. Whoa, I'm not going to do too much talking. I'm just going to more or less focus on the, hopefully you guys aren't being bounced around too much. Next time I'm going to bring my tripod and, set you guys up on that. This is one of the bad hills. Woo! My arson was sliding all over the place. Come on, Bessie, come on. I really need to get the four-wheel drive fixed on this, but my mechanic is gone to Toronto. Okay, come on, this last little hill. This is the other bad hill. Bump! Oh. And I hate this because it's not good for the motor. I'm spinning. Come on, come on, come on! After I get up here, I can slow it down a bit, but. Oh. You definitely need four-wheel drive if you live in the mountains. I got no traction at all right now. The tires are just spinning, 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 and obviously the plow has not been back. Oh, if I had four-wheel drive, though, I wouldn't have to worry about this. I could just cruise on up here. So hopefully he'll be all right, and I don't have to worry too much, but I say he's in better hands there than he is at home, so we're not prayers, but if you guys are, you can send a prayer his way if you'd like. Oh, we're almost up here. So usually, well, sometimes it takes me 5 minutes to get up here, but when I'm doing 50, 60 kilometers, whoa. There, guys, we're almost there. I gotta go to my parents' place and pick up my kid. Oh, my back is sore. We're almost. else at the top, and then I'll put you guys away. I know it's a boring, boring old video, but... And then I'll go home, and I'll get this edited, because I got a couple clips from today. Just put them together, and this is one of the ways here. Oh, you can't even see in there how we used to get back to the camp, but now we go a totally different way. Just up this hill here. And then you'll see some civilization. Oh! Ta-da! Alright, I'm gonna put you guys away so I don't look like a bad neighbor driving with a phone in my hand. And see you guys after.